it goes in favor of both the countries.
Okay.
India is also, I think, equally strong as compared as when we compare it with China. These two countries are the major part of this zone, Asia, which contributes a lot to the development of not only this zone but the entire world. But still, China is concerned better than, as far as the economy is concerned, it was considered to be better than India. Of course, you must have heard and learned that now China's economy is also going down and they are also facing a lot of problems. And what I personally feel, that whenever a country which goes to this extent on the economic front, if they start facing problem, that will have a very disastrous and very huge impact on their country. As far as India is concerned, of course, so far we were depending on China to a great extent. Our 5% of the total exports was only to the China, whereas we were importing total imports to the extent of 11% from China. So now it is the need of the hour that we should reverse. We should more export to the China and less import should come from China to India. India and China are two rising superpowers and both the countries are at such a stage that no one can ignore each other, neither the world can ignore both the countries. The second thing is that both the countries know their strategic and economic strength. Chinese President Xi Jinping is China's strongest leader in decades. He aims to propel his nation to the top of the world. He is workaholic, ambitious, and still down to earth. His work style is very rigorous and his rhythm is very fast. He has consolidated power more rapidly than any other Chinese leader. And as far as our country is concerned, our leader, Honorable Prime Minister, is also quite strong, capable, and he is also concerned and proactive for building a strong relationship with the other countries of the world, so that ultimately it has, we should have our recognition in the world map, and world should recognize that India is also a strong country. So Prime Minister is very proactive in that direction, and he is showing a direction to the country also, that how to achieve a strong position in the world. Of course, this is the beginning. I think after some time, maybe a couple of years after, we will definitely find the results coming out of the policies which the new government is taking. In international context, India can get more backing from other countries, because we have seen that our Prime Minister has been visiting other countries to get their support, to get our recognition in the world map. Prime Minister Modi knows his strength, and so he directly took up the matter of incursion in Chumar, and Xi Jinping had to act on it. Showing strength is only one way in modern bilateral relations. There are many other ways to deal with. Economy is a sharper weapon with bloodless effect. In this context, we have to think beyond the border. The business will be the new keyword, and we should make ourselves more capable to give a fitting reply to China. Of course, there was a war in 1962. And of course, we were defeated, there was a constrained relationship between India and China after that. And but it was open; the ties were normalized in 1998. And Vajpayee's visit, Atal Bihari Vajpayee's visit in 2003, paved a path for rapid development in trading. Now, leaders of both the countries have realized that India and China can make Asia center stage of the world economy. This can be the beginning of the era, new era in our relationship. Shades of this new thinking have promptly appeared in Chinese approach. Xi Jinping pledged to invest $20 billion over 5 years. China will invest in power sector in Vadodara and automobile sector in Pune. China is keen to help us in railways. It can give us technical support for the fast trains. Both countries have decided to develop a smart city in each country. These are the signboards that every citizen of both the countries should read. BRICS Bank is a grand example to show the world that how the wind is flowing. Banking, trade, education, tourism, pharmaceuticals, communications and power generation are some sectors where two countries can cooperate. Banking is one field where India stands better than China. And as far as the BRICS Bank is concerned, we all have seen that both the powerful countries of this area have decided that the headquarters will be in their area, in China, Beijing. But the first chairman of that bank will be from India. So that is a great honor and recognition to our country as far as this BRICS is concerned. We may have border disputes, but we can't stagnate ourselves on that point. Those issues will definitely be solved. Our rapid development in economic field will realize China our strength. Then we can force China to go two steps back on border issues. Of course, our intention is not to have a conflicting attitude, but we want development of both the countries so that ultimately development of the entire this zone will take place. I sincerely think that this workshop would have definitely helped each one of you to understand these delicate details about Indo-China relationship and how these relationships can be extended further. I heartily admire efforts of Rambau Malgi Prabhudini in showing concern on this important issue and organizing a workshop. I also express my thanks for calling me here as once again as a chief guest and giving me the opportunity to express my ideas. Thank you. Thank you very much.
धन्यवाद गुप्ता सर. मी आता आपले अध्यक्ष लखन जगत शेखरकर यांना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी अध्यक्षीय समारोह करावा.
आज के इस समारोह के मुख्य अतिथि श्री आर के गुप्ता जी, प्रबुद्धि के सर्वोसर्वा इसमें रविंद्र साठे जी, इस कार्यक्रम की जिन्होंने कल्पना की भगवान दातार सर, हमारे प्रमुख जो वक्ता गण इसमें आए थे और तमाम साथियों. पिछले दो दिन में हमने काफी कुछ विषयों पर चर्चा की चीन संबंध के बारे में, लेकिन आपने एक देखा होगा कि एक ही विषय के कितने सब विषय होते हैं, कितने पहलू होते हैं, और यदि हम उन पहलुओं में ना जाएं तो संभवतः हमारा जो एंड प्रोडक्ट होता है वो उतना पूरा नहीं होता है. विशेष तौर पर जब पत्रकार जगत की बात करते हैं तब पत्रकार जगत का राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा, राष्ट्र का स्वरूप, राष्ट्र की इमेज, इससे अत्यंत घनिष्ठ संबंध है, ऐसी मेरी मान्यता है. जब मैं सेना में था तब मैं स्ट्रेटेजिक प्लानिंग डिपार्टमेंट का सर्वोसर्वा था. फॉर योर नेशन 20 years, 30 years, 35 years तक यू टू प्लान. और मनोवैज्ञानिक युद्ध पद्धति का भी मैं उस विभाग का अध्यक्ष था. वेयर द मीडिया हैज द लार्जेस्ट रोल टू प्ले, इट इज द परसेप्शन ऑफ द पीपल अबाउट यू, हाउ पीपल परसीव यू. सो द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ परसेप्शन मैनेजमेंट, व्हेन वी से अमेरिका इज अ सुपर पावर, आई डोंट थिंक यू हैव कम अक्रॉस एनी ह्यूमन बीइंग फ्रॉम अमेरिका हु हैज द थ्री लेग्स और एन एक्स्ट्रा हैंड और एक्स्ट्रा ईयर. ऑल द ऑर्गन्स ऑफ द बॉडी इज सेम. व्हाट मेक द नेशन सुपर पावर? इज इट ओनली द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स? इज इट द हाइट ऑफ द अमेरिकन्स? इज इट द फेयर लुक्स ऑफ द अमेरिकन्स? प्रोबेबली इट इज द कलेक्टिव विजडम, द कलेक्टिव पावर, द रिजॉल्व, द डिजायर ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ द नेशन टू रिमेन सुपर पावर, नॉट ओनली टू अटेन द स्टेटस ऑफ अ सुपर पावर, टू रिमेन अ सुपर पावर एज लॉन्ग एज यू वॉन्ट टू बी. There's a saying that you may climb the Mount Everest, it is very difficult to stay there for long. So to achieve the status of a superpower, a big power, and to maintain it, that is where the perception management comes. Throughout the world, people have a desire to go to America, superpower, superpower, superpower. Having created the perceptions among the people, you have to manage it. The perception should not change. That get correlate to image management. हम समझते हैं कि उस व्यक्ति का इमेज बड़ा अच्छा है, उसकी प्रतिभा बड़ी बहुत अच्छी है. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द परसेप्शन यू हैव इमेज ऑफ दैट पर्सन, यू हैव इमेज ऑफ द नेशन, And if you fail in perception management and image management, then be prepared for the consequence management. It can happen to individuals. I think Dr. was mentioning in the morning, this is what I picked up from you. And coming from a young mind, I salute to you. I salute you, wisdom, sir. I exclaim. And the karmi must have gamati var lo ki shane vidrava mati rata tum khare shane tumhi se sir. Honestly. I am picking up this from your last sentence that you made, I made a start. If you don't manage your perception of the people about you, and you don't manage your own image, then be ready for the consequence management. And I think this is what Ram Bhav Maji Prabhuji ji karte hai. They are helping us, bringing us together, exchange of views, giving you the ideas, how to manage yourself, how to manage the perceptions, how to manage the image, and become a powerful nation. And this is what Dr. Gupta also tried to mention. Look at the similarity between the two. I am not going to war. I think we discussed enough. Today is the 21st century, I mentioned, is the century of Indras. There are Shailendra, there are Mahendra, there are Yadavendra, there are Raghavendra, there are Devendra, there are Narendra. What is the Indra? It is the people who have been able to control their Indriya. Panch Indriyon ko aapne apne vash mein karke, unka upyog karke, jo naro mein Indra ban gaya, wo Narendra ban gaya. Simple as that. So today is the century, is the century of knowledge power. I mentioned about this century. The more knowledgeable you are, that's what Dr. Sabas is mentioning, the more knowledgeable you are, the more powerful you will be. Now to how to project that knowledge to the people and to the entire humanity that you are knowledgeable, you are powerful. Again, the role of media, Prasar Madhyamanta, far mota mota tujhyamadhe sahyog asto. There is similarity in the leadership. If you see the background history of the present president of China, his father was put into jail, in the confinement, and as a young boy, the dagda phodo tode, the present president of China. He was in confinement. And then when he came back to the township, studied mechanical engineering. Look at our prime minister. Having gone through struggle hard during his childhood, he became what he became, and now he is into the social engineering, what Dr. Sabha was mentioning in the morning. Engineering of the social causes, the engineering of the people. So there is a similarity of thought. There's a cherished desire among the people in China to go and study in USA. Let the dream come true. His own daughter is studying in USA. The present president's daughter is studying in USA at the moment. Every child from a well-to-do family got one permission to go to USA and study, acquire knowledge. Here the prime minister of ours, who want our young graduates, philosophers, professors to go abroad and teach the people in USA and all the world what he's calling the Knowledge Export Corporation. One is to acquire the knowledge, the other is to export the knowledge. You can export the knowledge provided you own the knowledge. How can you export? And that knowledge has to be surplus to you. But having met your own requirement, then you are in a position to export what you think can be of useful to you. And here again, I am a firm believer of one thing, that the media plays a very big role, the role of media. Please don't take me wrong, sir. There are limitations on the part of electronic media. Electronic media is a momentary thing. You will come, bring a mic, tell him, sir, aap kya bolte hain, aapke bare mein kya sochna hai, jail mein mein kaam. And very rightly they have evolved, but I must salute to these people. They said, we want a bite from you. Now which bite? Bite is a bite. It depends on how you use that word bite. Koi chawala magta hai, koi bolala magta hai, koi bite. So you take a bite from here, you take a bite here, concoct a story and put it there. Electronic media's things are momentary. They are momentary of nature. It can influence the mind for a time being. It can create a provocative environment. It can be other way. My firm belief is the print media impact is lasting impact. You read when you don't have to do. Loko katrane kaapun thiyotat. So that the same thing can be utilized later on. You circulate the things. So I don't think in Indian context particularly, the power and the role of print media will ever get reduced. I don't think so. It will remain. Because print media can use right up to the auto rickshaw driver or anybody.